Now then, that story I started earlier. Grungnir, the simple-minded stone giant, was invited by Odin to his palace in Asgard. There he gives Grungnir his fill of mead and goads him into all manner of boasts and antics, all for the amusement of the court. I was there. I saw the Aesir laugh as Grungnir leapt upon his shield and swore he'd kill us all and take our womenfolk back to Jotunheim. Let's pick this up later, then.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Hey, Sindri. Have you met Mimir?
If you mean the severed head that keeps blinking at me, please, keep it away. There is no possible way that's hygienic.
Oh, that's nice. Lovely to see you too, Sindri. Nob.
I don't suppose you can try keeping that clean. Enjoy cutting trees. You just cut trees with that, right?
And for the youngster. And we're back to you. Come back anytime.
Please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
I still can't believe a son would kill his own father. That's crazy, right? I know, we only got one side of the story. But come on! His own father? I mean, I get angry at... you sometimes, but...
Do you?
I mean, sometimes, yeah. A little. But I'd never stab you in the back.
No. I imagine not.
This clan really didn't want anyone coming in. How are we supposed to get through?
There must be a way to lift the gate.
Maybe with the big water wheel.
My thought as well.
ready.
When are you angry?
What?
With me. When?
Oh. I guess... sometimes when you don't think I can do something, but I can.
It is not always easy to know what...
It's okay. I get it. I'm little. Where's that whetstone, I wonder?
Ah, yes. See that poison. Not a fan.
Quiet, head.
What happened over there?
This is the sun.
That ghost sun? How do you know?
The sigil. It matches the dagger we found in his father's back. He stood his ground, but it was not enough.
They betrayed him.
Betrayal begets betrayal. My guess, the young one murdering his dad didn't sit well with the others.
He thought himself ready to lead. It cost him his life.
I guess.
Look there, lad. By his feet.
The whetstone!
Yes. They used it to smash his face in.
They did? Ew.
Focus up!
Oh!
If Sindri wants it, it must be really useful.
Well, lad, Reavers have very specific priorities. If it's not shiny and you can't eat or drink it, might as well use it as a blunt object.
Boy.
Sir. Hey, it's another treasure map.
Read it.
This says, False Leader. I've seen it written all over this place.
Look here.
Yes, sir. There's a scroll here. It belonged to the... son. Wow. This goes on and on. Father, forgive me. Filled with remorse. Forget my actions.
Had he thought before taking action, there would be no need for regret, yes?
Yeah. Maybe we should bring this to his father, back at the storeroom.
What's that down there?
Where to next? Which way? There's something down there.
Right there. We were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Odin had invited Hrungnir to his palace in Asgard, getting the simple giant drunk to amuse the court. And we'll pick this up later.
You didn't happen to find the whetstone, perchance.
We found your whetstone.
Oh, wonderful! This staining is unusual.
The Reavers used it to smash another Reaver's face in.
Oh, wonderful. Here, for your trouble. I can't wait to test out the new whetstone. It may not look like much, but it's practically humming with magic. I've needed a new one after my brother borrowed the last one. I saw him spit on it.
To lube it up!
He said.
I didn't ask for it back.
Now don't be a stranger.
Right then. We were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Odin had invited Hrungnir to his palace in Asgard, getting the simple giant drunk to amuse the court. Then Thor shows up. Does he laugh? Oh, no. Thor takes one look at the drunken stone buffoon and brings down Mjolnir on his head so hard that he's got chunks of Hrungnir in his own skull to this day. Thor is so startled by the faceful of rock, he doesn't notice Hrungnir's body topple right onto him with a sickening crunch. And again, the roars of laughter echo through the palace halls.
That's an awful story, Mimir. Nothing like the ones Mother told me.
Let that be a lesson, my son. Truth is seldom so pretty as myth and legend.
To the city?
I'm not entirely sure, lad. It was abandoned long before Jormungandr came to town and flooded the place.
I wonder what it was like to live here.
There's something down there.
have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Gnúmgagok, the great void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced. And we'll pick this up later.
Guy's part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
We've seen these runes before. But it's the kind I still can't read. Getting a letter here and there. But we need the rest of the language disc.
We were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Regarding Ymir. Primordial fire and ice met in the great void, producing water.
Water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. And we'll pick this up later.
it up.
Enemies down.
What are you fools doing back here? Come to pilfer my boots and small clothes?
We found your son. He was betrayed too. And we found part of his journal. It sounded like he regretted killing you.
Fat lot of good that does me.
How'd he go out? He died fighting?
We found four corpses near his. They were decapitated.
Ha! Vandrid always did keep his sword nice and sharp. A lesson he picked up from me.
He's a backstabbing bastard, but knowing he's in Valhalla sets me at ease. Thanks.
We did a good thing. I'm glad we came back here.
That thief did not deserve the peace you gave him.
Maybe so. Still, it feels good to help people. Even the dead ones.
So much like your mother.
Why? Is that a piece of my brain?